New York. What could be worse than constant rain in the suffocating gray jungle of concrete and glass? Oh no, not another power outage. Where are those candles? Finally, let me tell you my story. This little girl in the picture? That's me, Ashley. And this is my grandmother. When I was a child, we used to spend a lot of time together. My grandma lives in our family's manor in Maine, right off the coast of the Atlantic Ocean. It's a wonderful and peaceful place. I really enjoyed being there as a child, playing in the beautiful grounds. I remember long walks along the coastline, watching the ocean waves crash into the rocks, and feeling the fresh sea breeze on my face. But yesterday I received a letter in the post. I'm sure it was from my grandma. Inside there was an unsigned postcard with a photo of a lighthouse. Nothing else. I tried to call grandma on the phone, and I kept calling all day, but there was no answer. She's always at home. She always answers the phone. I had a bad feeling about this. I was too worried to sleep, so I got in my car and drove through the night. The house looked eerie in the darkness, strewn with debris from the stormy weather, almost abandoned. Grandma, where are you? What's happened to you? Hold tight, I'm coming. Grandma? Hello? Anyone home? Oh, this is really strange. And too quiet. Grandma's handwriting. What does it say? What is that? A wolf? I haven't seen this statue before. Oh, the very look of it gives me chills. It's tangled. I need to try to rearrange the gems so that the bead chains don't intersect.
Thank you.
my God! That's my grandma's neighbor, Mr. Oxford! What happened to him? Why is he lying here in my grandma's cellar? Is he dead? Who would do such a horrible thing? The door won't open until I fix this lock. Looks like I must arrange the gears in the right order. Grandma? Where are you? Anyone home? So dusty. No one has cleaned up around here for a long time. chilly in here. Oh, the radiator's cold and the window's wide open. Looks like the key has been deliberately broken. I need to rearrange the parts to make it whole again. It's a note from my grandma. Who would have tried to burn it? Why? Grandma!
Thank you.
This is the chair Grandma wrote about. Oh, it's so dusty. No one has cleaned up around here for a long time.
Thank you.
This picture, I have seen it somewhere before. I think it was a stained glass or a mosaic. I should try and color it in a way that parts of the same color are not adjacent to each other. Oh, it's so dusty. No one has cleaned up around here for a long time. My grandfather's old car. Doesn't look too bad.
Thank you.
Looks like the way is blocked. It's unwise to walk around in the woods at this time of night looking for another path. So dusty. No one has cleaned up around here for a long time. Oh. Oh, it's so dusty. No one has cleaned up around here for a long time. Some numbers and letters have been carved in wood. Could that be the code? That wolf's head looks quite strange. This looks like a puzzle lock. I need to get rid of all these stones by sliding them towards each other. Hmm. bathroom is completely ruined. Mr. Mortimer? Are you all right? What are you doing here? He doesn't look good. I probably should follow my grandma's advice and give him some brandy.
Thank you.
This brick looks like it's about to fall out. What if I... It's dark in there. The bridge is destroyed. It needs to be fixed before I can cross the stream. Looks like one of the crystals has fallen off.
Thank you.
This place. I've never been here before. What purpose could it serve? Another dead man. What in the world has happened here? Who's killed them? I need to be very careful. The clockwork mechanism doesn't look too complicated, but it's incomplete. I need to use the sliders to activate all the gears.
Thank you. Thank you.
Is that a cobweb? What kind of spider weaves a web of this size?
Thank you. That's the cabin. Grandma must be inside. Grandma! Grandma!
This is some kind of fluid-based lock. How bizarre. I guess I should rearrange these pipes so that the fluid reaches the green lamp. Someone was here just a moment ago. The tea in the mug is still warm.
Thank you.
Oh my god, who are you? What are you? Get away from me! Grandma! Grandma! Oh, I'm so happy to see you.
How did this happen, Grandma? What is going on? For her entire life, my grandma has been hiding a terrifying secret. A secret which nearly cost her her life. A horrible curse cast upon her long ago transformed her into a werewolf, the savage creature from myths and legends. On the night of a full moon, the beast within would take control of her body, and only one thing could prevent this from happening. A special potion, brewed from a variety of rare herbs, could stop the process and keep her in human form. The potion was so effective that no one has ever suspected anything until very recently, when Grandma was caught outside as the sun set and the full moon rose. Some neighbors saw her begin to transform, and in a panic, they attacked her. But she fled into the house to find her potion. Mr. Oxford ran into the house after her. He chased Grandma into the cellar, where she had gone to fetch the herbs for the potion. Grandma fought him off and barely managed to escape, locking Mr. Oxford in the cellar. Another neighbor, Mr. Mortimer, had followed them into the house. He heard noises coming from the cellar and assumed it was the beast. He armed himself, broke into the cellar, and in the darkness, he sliced Mr. Oxford's throat before realizing what he had done. Realizing what had happened, and seeing his clothes covered in blood, he collapsed in shock. Grandma tended to him and gave him some brandy before she fled. Since I arrived, Grandma has been guiding me from the shadows and watching over me throughout this entire time. She made sure no harm came to me until the very moment of our reunion. A huge weight has been lifted off my heart. I have found Grandma, unharmed and well. Now we have to ensure that nothing like this ever happens again.